Hey, look, a tripod. I'll let myself out now. Hello, filmmakers. Ash here, and welcome to Film It Yourself. I recently needed to buy a new tripod so that I could, well, do these videos. And while I absolutely love my Manfrotto tripod, I didn't necessarily have the budget to spend hundreds of dollars on another one. So I did some research and landed on this beauty, the E-Image two-stage aluminum tripod system with a GH01 pan tilt fluid head. Whew, man, that's a mouthful. And I gotta say, I've been pleasantly surprised with the quality of this guy, especially since it only cost me $169. Yep, you heard me right, only $169. So today I wanted to do an E-Image video tripod review because I think it might just be the best budget tripod for 2021. So let's go over the pros first. So the first pro is that it comes with a clip that can keep the legs together. It's this little thing down here. It goes all the way around and then you can clip the legs so that they don't come apart. It also comes with removable rubber feet, as you can see here. Then you can stake it into the ground when using it outdoors if you remove those, which is super handy. Now, as I said, it's a two-stage system, which means you can adjust the height at 2 points. You can adjust it here, and you can also adjust it up here. Now it extends up to 63 inches total height, just over 5 feet, and a minimum height of 31 inches, which is what you're seeing here. Now this model comes with the GH01 fluid head mount, and it's my favorite part because it makes leveling the tripod super easy. So you just loosen it here and then you can move the ball mount around until the level in the ball is level and you tighten and then you're good. On my Manfrotto tripod, I had to use the legs to level it and it was a serious pain. Now it's a 65 millimeter bowl. And as I said, you can twist it and level it with the bubble head. You can also adjust the pan and tilt. With this little knob here, you can adjust the pan. And then with this knob here, you can adjust the tilt. You can also adjust the tension of the tilt drag. With this guy here, you can make it more intense or looser. So for example, here we go, pretty loose, a little harder there. Next up, it's got a quick release plate, which you can release right here. And it just pops right up, and quick release plates are great because you can quickly put your camera on and move back and forth. And then it also has the ability to move the plate back and forth so that you can better balance and level your camera, which is pretty great. For example, if you had a really heavy lens that was very front heavy, you could adjust this and pull it back so that the center weight of your camera was more correct and better for the tripod. And the tripod plates has the standard tripod screw-in quarter inch screw size, which is great for most cameras. And it has the quick snap design so that it snaps up like that and you can just push it in and it closes nice and tightly in. The handle is also totally adjustable, so you can move it about and adjust it to however you see fit, like so. And I also really like that the handle has a nice grip on it, which is really comfortable and great. Now it can handle up to 11 pounds of weight, so you can really support a built-out camera with this guy, which is pretty great. And it comes with a bag, and you guys know how much I love bags. So here's the bag that it comes with, and it comes with an adjustable strap that you can adjust, and it has a bit of padding here, which is really great so that it can kind of support on your shoulder and not be too rough. And then inside, open it up, it's got a little interior pocket, which is really great. And then it also has clamps so that it can clamp your tripod in place, which is awesome if you're worried about it moving around in transport. So the cons for this guy, there's not a lot of cons for this guy. However, the biggest one for me is that it doesn't have the clamp style legs, which I prefer But the trade-off for the money is pretty great. The clamp style lathes can really save you time when you're just quickly going through and securing, but hey, it was under $200, can't complain. Also, the fluid head is just okay. It's not the best. I still use my Manfrotto for any panning or tilting shots I might want to do for B-roll. So just keep in mind, if you really want to do a lot of panning or tilting with this guy, you might want to upgrade the head on it. It is very lightweight, which is a pro, but it's also a con for stability. So if you have a really heavy camera system, you might need a bigger tripod system. However, for a DSLR or mirrorless camera, this guy works great and it's very stable and wonderful and lightweight enough to carry it around with you everywhere. Other than that though, this is a really good budget tripod for filmmaking if you're on a budget and need something better than a cheap $30 tripod that you got from Walmart. I also love using it as my second camera tripod when shooting product review videos. So not a main camera tripod, but great for a locked off second shot. Now I'll put the link to this guy in the description below and let me know what you think about this tripod. Do you think it's worth it for the budget or should people save up for a more expensive Manfrotto instead? Also, don't forget to subscribe and hit that notification bell so you never miss a video. All right, I gotta get back to feeding Spence snap peas. If he doesn't get his daily limit, he gets grumpy.